Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of Vacation Bible School, the Honorable Mayor Mr. Oscar Mayer of Bricksburg, the capital city of Legoland, is about to address the good citizens of our fine city.
106 years ago, our pastor and his wife brought forth to this church a new summer tradition of Vacation Bible School. Dedicated to the proposition that all boys and girls are created to experience the joy and love of God. So, in harmony with this great tradition, I, Mayor Oscar Mayer, welcome you, boys and girls, princesses, superheroes, and VBS friends, to this Legoland city of Bricksburg, where all week long we will learn from the Bible that we are built for God and where each and every day, everything is awesome!
Everything is cool when you're part of a team. Everything is awesome.
Have you heard the news? Everyone's talking. Life is good because everything's awesome.
Man, I feel so good right now. I can sing this song for hours.
Everything is awesome.
Until we showed up and decided to start behaving like big bad bullies and totally take over Vacation Bible School.
Wait just a minute, you big bad bunch of big bad bullies.
You might think you're super tough and cool, but everyone knows that princesses rule and bullies drool.
Cute. Real cute. But your cute little chains and magic fairy tale vests, they don't stand a chance against our master Lego building skills!
The big bad Dan is right. We are building the most ginormous tower of Lego power ever built, only in the history of forever.
You tell him. We are going to build a ginominous tower of babble blabble babble.
That's right. Our tower is going to be so big. It's going to be the biggest tower of babble ever that it's going to make everyone babble.
Anyway, it's going to be so awesome that everyone's going to realize how cool we are, and then everyone's going to bow down to us, and we're going to rule the world!
Hey now, big bad bullies. You guys are so full of yourselves. I mean, there's no way you can build the world's largest tower of power.
And no one is going to bow down and worship you.
No way!
Way!
Hey.
No way!
Way!
Now, I don't know what's going on here, but in my world, the S stands for hope.
Hey, Superman! I see you brought your little friends. Little Bat Boy! And who are you, young lady?
Call me young lady one more time, and I will permanently zip your lips, Dan.
I'm so scared. No! I'm not scared because I'm the best ever, and I'm the greatest master Lego builder in the world, and I'm so great that I deserve to be worshipped, and I deserve to rule the world!
All right, look, maybe I won't kill you, but I don't have to save you either. and there is no one who is going to bow down to you. And this city is about to show you it's filled with people who believe in good. Wow, that was a great line.
That was a great line, but here's the thing. We're running late right now to meet with our agent at the movie studio.
That's right. It's a sequel about a sequel that goes to the sequel to the series of sequels all about us. We don't have time to save VBS right now. We gotta get going. Come on, guys. Let's fly.
Am I even in this movie?
Well, that was fantastic.
Jeez. Now they've flown.
Oh. Yeah.
Hashtag superhero problems, I guess. Hashtag that was disappointing. Hashtag at least the Disney princesses are still here.
Yeah. Hashtag magic time.
Actually, our calendar is quite full. We have a parade in 20 minutes. And then we're going to the ball. And I just got a text from home. Sneezy ran out of Kleenex again. Aren't they so sweet? But this was really fun. We'll be sure to go to lunch sometime. Real soon.
Bye!
Woo-wee! I ain't seen that many people leave the scene of a crime since my Uncle Jim Bob took a roadkill skunk and he smoked it because he ran out of chicken, y'all.
Wow. Just wow, Billy Ray. Wow.
Hey! Looks like all your superhero friends are flying away!
Yeah, and where are your magic Disney princesses?
yeah, and where did all of your... Well, I guess that's pretty much everyone. Big bad bullies rule!
We're the best! We're gonna build the greatest Tower of Babel ever!
You guys! What are we gonna do? I mean, who's gonna defeat the big bad bullies now?
Hey, I have an idea. Why don't you call your brother, Lego Dude, and Sheldon. Sheldon's really smart, and Lego's the fastest Lego builder ever.
Yeah, I'll call him right now, FaceTime him, and I think they're up at the Mall of America at Legoland right now. Here, let me call. It's dialing.
To the right. Move it to the left. Take it to the right. Move it to the left. Take it to the right. Move it to the left. Take it to the right. Here we go.
here.
But then the Big Bad Bully showed up and we're like, what is going on? And they're like, we're going to build this huge dark tower. We said, no way. And they said, way. And they said, we said, no way. And then the superheroes and the princesses left. So there's nobody left here to like to help us to feed them. And so we called you. And then you and Sheldon were like, you're up in like Mall of America. And then you flew in the Millennium Falcon down here. And then you climbed down the roof and you're in here. And now you're here. So you got to help.
That's on the half of it, dude. Now they want us to bow down and worship them too.
Yeah.
Can you believe that?
Hashtag Lego Dude and Sheldon to the rescue.
Yeah.
By my calculations, we are exactly right on time.
Yeah, right on time, Sheldon. Your time is practically perfect.
Big Bad Dan, he's right again. We just have one more brick to put on the top, and then the most ginormous Lego tower in the history of the world will be finished.
That's right. And then you're going to worship us because we are the best and the most powerfulest est.
No.
No.
Well, well, well.
The time has finally come. All you powerless little people. You've never seen anything like this before because there's never been anything so big and so powerful built before. I present to you the most incredible, ginormous Lego Tower of Babel! Yeah!
By my calculations, that's really big.
Well, Sheldon, it is really big, and there's nothing wrong with the tower, actually. The problem is in the hearts of the people who built it. That's where the problem is. They have too much pride. They brag too much about what they do, and so they don't have any room for the real power, the power of God. You know, the Bible says this, right? Am I there yet?
What verse is that in, though?
Luke chapter 18, verse 14 says, those who exalt themselves will be humbled. And those who humble themselves will be exalted.
That's it. That's in Luke chapter 18, verse 14, if you want to check it out yourself.
That's right, Sheldon.
Yeah.
It's a good one.
Well, Lego dude. Why don't we just settle this once and for all? Me versus you in a Lego building contest. My Tower of Babel and my Tower of Power against your whatever you can build.
Whatever you build.
I accept the challenge. I'll build something.
Yeah.
All right, boys and girls, let's have a Lego building contest. Whoever can build the biggest and most powerful building wins.
It's gonna take you at least 3 years to build something as amazing as us.
I just need 3 seconds, Big Bad Dan.
Yeah.
He only needs 3 seconds. Okay, this is the moment. Are you ready? Lego Dude, are you ready?
I'm ready, Mayor.
On your marks, get set, build!
get your telescope so we can get a closer look at it.
Yeah, sweet victory. Big bad bullies rule.
Brother, I've never seen you lose a Lego contest before. I mean, that's why we call you Lego Dude.
Don't worry, little brother. I didn't lose. It's not over. See, what they're missing is the power that's in this little cross. Come here. I'll show you. Come on, you guys. Come here. Because it's not what we do, and it's not what we make, and it's not about how great we are. It's about how great God is.
Yeah.
It's not about how powerful we are. It's about how powerful God is. I mean, if you want real power, and if you want real greatness, we have to bring this to God. So we bring our little gifts, whatever we've got, and we bring them before the throne of God. And what does the Bible say? We humble ourselves. We humble ourselves before a holy God so that we can experience the real power.
Step 13, enjoy popular music. Mm-hmm.
Oh. Everything is awesome.
Oh my gosh, I love this song. It's there somewhere.
Hit it one more time.
There it is.
Wow.
That was humbling.
It's a Monday.
I hope we get a refund for that thing. But the point is still there. See, when we humble ourselves, sometimes things don't always go right.
Nope.
When human beings are in charge of dropping the veil in front of the cross. But the God who's always there is always there for us. He's there for you and you and you. He's there for you and you and you and you and you and me and everybody. And that's where the real power comes from. I mean, look at that cross compared to that little thing. Where's the real power? The real power is in God's love. So what did we learn here today, everybody? Dude!
You don't need to shower me with flowers on a tower every hour to keep me from going sour.
That's right.
Because all my power comes from God.
Yes, it does. Let's stand up and sing a song.